up, y'all? It's the Maginine. It's time for another one. So, being that we are in full knee-deep into Gamergate version 2.0, it just seems people want to continue to just, like, make things bad for themselves. I mean, we got the Black Girl Gamer thing going on. Obviously, we had the Sweet Baby Ink thing going on. But right now, I want to talk about Xbox. You see, even if this came out prior to all of the whole Sweet Baby Ink thing, which kind of like led us to where we are right now, I'm just trying to figure out, why would you think this is a good idea? Like, I'm so confused as to what happened to just make a good game. I mean, you got to think about this here, right? We went from, like, for me, pole position, which was like basically just, you know, square pixels, right? To obviously what we have now. But that whole journey that we went from, like, pole position, right? To now, it's like nobody cared about all the stuff that they put in this, these new directives, I should say. But let's talk about it real fast. This is from that parkplace.com. It says, Microsoft recommends that game developers question if female characters wear proper clothing and if games are reinforcing any negative gender stereotypes. So, this right here is what Xbox is looking forward to. Not the well-rounded Tifa Lockhart. This is what they're looking forward to in their games, right? And, you know, let's get right down to the meat and potatoes of this. Let me scroll down here. So this is the question to consider. Let's blow that up a little bit. So here are the questions to ask. It says, are you telling new stories or sharing new perspectives on a within a product experience? Okay. Do all of your characters slash player depictions look the same? I mean, a question like that might have been, like, something you might ask, like, again, in gaming infancy, like, in, you know, the early 80s. You know, when you could only do so much. Like, perfect example, me being a super fan of Street Fighter. Street Fighter, when you played it, it was player one, player two, and it was USA and Japan, which translate to Ken and Ryu, right? But back then, it was just USA and Japan, and it was just a color swap. But let's continue. What steps have you taken to ensure characters are represented respectively and authentically? Again, I'm trying to figure out where are we going with this? So have you validated assumptions you've made about your audience to check for blind spots or unintended stereotypes? Listen, I got a whole video coming up talking about some stuff like this. Because when you look at the mainstream, I don't want to go down the rabbit hole. We're going to focus. Because I'll end up spiraling if I start talking about how I feel about how the mainstream really reinforces stereotypes. But we'll keep continuing. Would you feel proud to show a member of the community of how their culture slash character is being depicted in your experience? How are the wide range of customers depicted within your products, content, portfolio, and communications? What process have you used to validate how different groups of people or cultures are represented in your experience? So, I'm going to stop right there for a second. Because we got the part that I'm going to get in, like, go hard on real fast, pause, is in the next column. But I just want to just bring something out here. These questions right here are so benign and stupid. If you were just making a game, perfect example. I'm a Final Fantasy guy. I love Final Fantasy. They have some ups and downs, obviously. It seems like recently they're struggling to get captivate people how they used to, which I get, especially with the single player versions of it. The Final Fantasy 14 is a free for all, right? Can't wait to get back on that. But my point is, Final Fantasy 16 is basically based on a European alternate universe with obviously Final Fantasy. To me, it would be like, I don't know, Game of Thrones if it was Final Fantasy, right? None of the characters in there looked like me, sounded like me. I'm from Brooklyn, New York. So the characters were all depicted from, you know, across the pond, right? I didn't care. I liked the game. Okay, see, if you stop worrying about that nonsense and just make a good game, you don't have to worry about that nonsense. Of course, you know, I don't have any screws loose, so I really don't worry about stuff like this, but, you know, that's where we are. But let's get into the part that really annoyed me. Let's scroll over to column B here. All right. Are you reinforcing any negative gender stereotypes? Are you unnecessarily introducing gender and gender barriers in your code or design? Are you creating playable female characters that are equal in skill and ability to their male peers? Are your female characters equipped with clothing and armor that fits their tasks? Do they have exaggerated body proportions? Does anybody ask that question about the male exaggerated body proportions? Or is it because, is there supposed to be some kind of a disconnect? Like, you know, listen. They're pixels. I want to see exaggerated forms of the male and female body in games. I don't need to see normal people. I don't need to see myself. I don't understand why this is such a hard concept. Listen, I'll put it to you like this here, right? Stellar Blade is coming out. And of course, that's getting a lot of heat just because, I don't know, the player, the female character in the game is attractive. Oh my God! Here's the deal. Nobody, and I repeat, nobody cares about whether or not the female is looking normal. What we want to see is extraordinary, male or female. Doesn't make a difference, right? Especially when you're playing the games. Obviously, there will be sometimes you can put different, you know, body types and stuff like that. But most likely, when it's your protagonist is supposed to be kind of like your superhero in your comic book. They're supposed to be your modern myth. That's who you're playing when you play these games, right? But if you're going to sit there and say, oh, they need to be like, I don't know, Karen and Walmart. I don't need to see Karen and Walmart. I need to see Eve and Stellar Blade. I need to see Tifa from Final Fantasy. Okay? That's what we need to see. I don't understand why that's such a big... Like, it doesn't seem like... It should be that hard to compute. But let's continue with this. When your story allows, do you show male characters who display a full range of emotions, including joy, sadness, and vulnerability? I don't see what that has to do with video games, but here we are. This is what percentage of screen time... on-screen presence speaking line heroes is held by different gender / racial identities. Do you have a process to review key decisions and within the lens of helping customers feel seen? Trash. Okay. Had this been 1970, you could go ahead and, while I would still say it would be dumb, but I would understand, because then you really needed to have those barriers broken, right? Because we're coming out of civil rights movement, all that stuff like that. Understandable where you can have something like this to be a key factor in your entertainment properties, right? When you're designing things. Not in 2024. It's to me, it just it's insane that we're acting like this is the 1960s when we're in 2024. There are black billionaires. We've had a black president. We have billionaire females. You know, it's you name it. We have it, especially in the West. Okay, where this matters, right? Obviously, it's around the world, and not everything's the same. But we're talking about with the gaming industry. This is a Western thing. Where it matters, as far as what they're trying to you know, portray here, doesn't make sense for 2024. It just doesn't. It does not make sense. Okay? And this whole thing where people need to see themselves, or you gotta have Karen from Walmart in your video games, this needs to stop. Nobody needs that. Nobody wants that. If you're the type of person that needs this or wants this, how about you just make your own little niche game and stop pushing this into the mainstream? Because in the mainstream, nobody needs this. We just want the game to be good, have the good storyline, have good-looking characters, and be done with it. I don't see why this is such a hard concept, but here we are. But anyway, how do you feel about Xbox's ridiculous mandates? And I know they're going to say it's not a mandate, but We know where we are right now. We know how this works, okay? Let me know how you feel about that. Like, subscribe. If you want to support the channel, you can hit that super thanks. Remember, you can't be good, be good at it. Peace.